Blimey, old chap, who turned the radio up?
Hi, I'm Eric B, and welcome to How the Buzz 88 in the Manchester region was created. I was educated at Ludford Street School in Crewe and also Dame Bank Avenue. In the region is still six of my brothers and three of my sisters. I went to Liverpool in the late 70s and got into music, where I was playing at the Gladray Club for quite a while, and doing a lot of local acts as well, you know, for charity and all that. Then I went to Manchester in, I'd say, the late 80s. Went in, you know, to Manchester and got into radio, got into pirate radio. Lots of radio stations
playing the people's music night and day. We had a phone call from this gentleman with a Scouse accent, yeah, a Liverpool accent, and it was Eric B. Well, we met up with him, it was actually Eric B. And he was a passionate man for music and radio. He told us that he'd just come from Liverpool, and he was interested in teaming up with us. At the time, we had a community radio station that was booming up in Manchester, and he joined us from that particular point. And we've been friends from that point onward. He's a loyal guy, really, who's stuck by us through thick and thin. And I remember one particular situation where, you know, things got a little bit tricky, and he's the only person of all the crew that actually stood his ground. And from that time, he actually gave him a maximum respect for that, yeah?
Yeah, I've known Eric B for quite some years now, and the station that he's been doing is quite a success in Manchester. I've done a few shows on there quite a few times, and they've got quite a good feedback from the public.
Yo, Eric, one thing, he ain't scared of no cameras, he ain't scared of DTI, we ain't scared of nobody, you know why? Because I know one of it, I know two of it, I know three of it, I know four of it, but one big boss army, and it comes from you. Yo, respect you. Give a round of applause for this man, yeah. Every time.
Shout going out to everyone in Withinshaw. We're missing the Buzz, 88 FM. Get it on, tune in.
Hi, I'm Jemima.
Hi, I'm Grove.
And we're from Manchester. We always listen to Buzz FM.
Original Buzz FM, man. What you say, rude boy?
Tiny G.
Yeah, man. Me there.
The Snowman.
What? Say what?
Buzz FM.
Yeah, man.
Manchester.
Big it up for real.
Boom. Boom.
FM has been busted many, many a times. Up until December, just recently gone, they've raided my premises, they've took my car, they've took my PC, they've took all of my vinyls, all of my CDs, all the paperwork, photographs with artists and things like that. So they continually keep raiding the station. We've been hit since then, full studio. They've got me on top of the roof when I've gone to put the transmitter up. So I've been to court three times this year already, and we're going back on the 4th of November to finalise what they're actually going to do with me, basically. But when the station is off, people are so depressed that they need the buzz, and basically, I suppose that's why we have to seem to carry on.
Hey, how you doing, Kerry?
And here's the main man himself, Mr. Eric B, he's live in the studio.
Hello, very good afternoon, everyone. Locked on to the big buzz. Don't forget, make sure you get down there tonight. Apparently, we've had so much inquiries, the management is going to open the doors at 9 o'clock, would you believe it? 9 o'clock, okay? The guy, the manager said, you know what I mean?
Right, so there you go, you can get there nice and early now.
This is the state that the DTI has left the studio in after they raided it on the 5th of December. That includes 4,000 records, also over 5,000 vinyls, camcorders, videotapes, all kind of paperwork, computers, pictures with artists, all kinds.
Hi, I'm Keith. I'm a transport manager here at Norton's. Eric is a nice lad, good driver, and I listen to Bus FM on a regular basis, especially when I'm travelling home in the evening.
With regards to Eric B on radio, well, he's passionate, as I said. It's in his blood. The radio situation is in his blood. There's not much you can do about it. You can't really take something out of a man that's already there. It's like squeezing blood out of a man. You can't do that. You can't squeeze radio out of him. When he actually went on to set up the station Buzz FM, that, without any doubt, became Manchester's number one. And what he did with that, actually, he continued a legacy that showed that we actually needed something within the community. Well, I'm sure he wasn't doing it for gains, because if you look at gains, he hasn't really gained anything out of it. He did it because he was showing us that the community needed something, yeah? Needed something, and Buzz was it. Everywhere you went, people were talking about Buzz. You know what I mean? It was number one. And I'm sure that's not what he was looking for. I'm sure that wasn't his aim to set up a radio station to become number one. He set up a radio station that was going to provide something for the community. And that's what it has done, actually.
Buzz FM, rock the telephone. Remember, we're in Australia right now. We've gone to Australia, Singapore, Taiwan, Jamaica. Where else have we got? We've got Canada. We've got Moscow. We're on the World Wide Web.
I'm Sharon, I live in Old Trafford and I always tune in to Buzz 88 FM.
Yes, we've been involved in the Manchester Carnival for a number of years, and we've had a number of people like helping out with lorries and stuff like that, like Norton's Transport, plus a variety of other companies that like the Building Centre. They've helped us out with trucks to take into the carnival, and it's been quite, you could say, successful.
Double eight.